And offense at the line, ready to go. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. They'll give it up to McCaffrey. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. And a very short pickup there across the 15 to the 16. Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of 4.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
The Panthers on third down, not good, 0 for 4 thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. Just a 1 yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's 4th down. And here's Joseph Charlton now as he'll kick it away for the second time. Fielded just inside the 20. A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And the Falcons will be taking over 1st and 10. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down. Jackson. He'll find his running back out of the backfield, Raymond Calais. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to 3rd down. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
3rd and 2, here's Jackson. Throwing left side, it's complete. And he is going to have a Falcons 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. A sizable 16-yard chunk there. The drive continues. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. And that throw there going to put him over 4,000 yards passing now for the season, maybe strengthening his MVP consideration.
And you figure with still a handful of games left to play, 5,000 yards is not totally out of the realm of possibility. The way he is playing, I think he's going to get there.
2 minutes remaining in this 1st half of football. Now a first and 10 at the 11. To throw is Jackson. Flushed out right. Throw over the middle, going to be caught here by Pitts. Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Give him 9 on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first. And he will score. Touchdown, Falcons. Anthony Schwartz, touchdown number 22 on the season. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. So the touchdown there, and that play, the tap pass, so simple, Charles, on the face of it, but what makes it so difficult for defenses to stop?
I think it's the precision and the quickness in which the play occurs, because the snap gets to the quarterback. He's essentially playing volleyball with it, just immediately just shoveling it forward. And when that receiver is at a full head of steam, if you don't take the edge away, he's got a chance to get to the corner and get upfield. But if you take the edge away, that's your chance to disrupt that play.
And no disruption there, that's for sure, as it winds up 6 points. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity. You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. This is McCaffrey on the give. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. 13 yards, first down, Panthers. This is McCaffrey. He'll be dropped shy of the 40 despite powering through the tackle. Grady Jarrett with the tackle.
At the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
So we have reached halftime now with the visiting Falcons out on top. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, the Falcons back to receive. They've got the lead, and they'll get this football as the second half gets underway. Taken at the goal line. And Patterson will not return it. It comes out to the 25. Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
56, now it's Jackson. And Jackson cannot get away, and he'll go down. Derrick Brown in there to get him. Sack number 14 for him on the year. Second, Throwing on second and long. Jackson, he's going to rifle one deep left side. Launches deep. A jump ball, and this is caught. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Now Jackson. He's going to try and go deep again. And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Anthony Schwartz with touchdown number 23 here on the year. And the Falcons push further out in front.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Ku able to connect on the extra point, and that will bump the lead up to 26. And this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And he returns this to the 22. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there at halftime, actually.
I mean, you think he might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and four. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down.
You know, we might start getting some props here in the booth. You know, that one that says the D and then the fence that you put up next to it. How about that? They brought out the jumbo package and still couldn't move them off the line of scrimmage enough to pick up that first down.
Impressive. They were ready defensively for that jumbo set. On is the punter, Charlton, now as he's able to get this one away. Officially just 27 yards there on the punt. And that will come the offense as they take over. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They had to go a long way on their last drive to score the touchdown. This time, they get at least a little bit more of a cushion with field position.
I have to think that with this field position, after what they did on the last drive, they might want to take a shot right now and try and cut down the length of the drive.
And now off to the races, right down the right side. Touchdown, Falcons. Raymond Calais. His ninth touchdown of the season. And the Falcons are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point by Ku, up and good. And the lead will swell by one more. Touchdown, here's Ku to kick off. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
Yeah, this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Here's Allen to throw it. There's Trimble, the tight end. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
There's a nice pickup right there. And after watching that play, I'm thinking about all the lost opportunities that they've had so far in this game. But right now, just focus on continuing to move the ball the way they did on the last play.
First down is Allen. Flush to his right. And Allen going to be intercepted for the third time. Picked by Tarvarius Moore. And nearly a touchdown as they finally stop him down at about the 3-yard line. He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you, and you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score?
And with the play clock winding down, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie, because usually your rookie season is in a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. Here comes the return from the very back of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side, because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
On play action, Allen And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. Fifth catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down.
They brought in a heavy set on third down, and that usually means running play, but we have seen them throw out of that formation. And sure enough, they snuck the tight end out on that one, wound up hitting him for a first down.
Eluding the pressure right. This one complete to Scott Miller. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A good pickup there, a 22. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Allen going to throw. Throw left side is complete on the diving effort. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Dancing to his left. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off inside the 10. And he'll be stopped shy of the 15 at the 14-yard line on the return. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. After the interception, here's Jackson. Looking left side, and it's complete. Touchdown, Falcons! A big play there. With his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Falcons are looking to make it two straight as they add on to this fourth quarter lead. Now Youngway Koo for the extra point. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the fourth quarter. This would be their third straight defeat. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. And I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
Escaping the pressure right. He's got a man. That's Marshall. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
On first down, Allen. And now here is another interception. Picked by Tarvarius Moore. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This taken in at the goal line. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They were coming off the extra week of rest, but this team started sluggish, and it really didn't get any better from there, and trailing big here in this fourth quarter. And my goodness, another interception. T.J. Green with a pick.
Well, partner, I got to tell you, I'm trying to think of something positive to say for this offense, but I'd have to be a spin doctor for that one. This has been a tough performance to watch.
And I think it's hard at this point to actually identify what's really gone wrong. I guess the catch-all is everything. Doesn't sound like real sharp analysis, but I don't have much else for you.
And the scoreboard just lopsided, and it's been ugly from the get-go.
A good pick up there, 26 yards.
These two teams, they met in Atlanta earlier in the year with the Falcons winning that game. So a win here in Charlotte would give them the season sweep.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 38.
Mike 56.
Let's go. Here's Jackson. That is caught by Mims. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
And 22 more yards there and another first down.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. From the gun, it's Jackson. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Robert Spillane. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Well, that's three picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season, because here we are
season
in December. Right, it is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake, after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
Oh, Allen cannot get away, and down he goes. Grady Jarrett in there to get him, and on the season now, that is 9 sacks for him. To try again after the sack. Allen, short throw, hauled in by Trimble. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Now whistles. Flag down, and I believe one of the Panthers got moving early. So the false start certainly doesn't help matters as they'll try again now, third and long.
You better be afraid of me. Number 16's coming. Check Mike, check Mike. Go, go, go.
Now Allen. Flushed out right. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Here's the Panthers punter now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. Averaging 50 yards a boot so far as this one's away. Fielded just inside the 30.
And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And a few kneel downs should come very close to finishing this one off, depending on whether or not we see any defensive timeouts. They still have two, but using them would just be prolonging. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Troy Pride. Well, they're not making it easy on themselves here down the stretch. Two picks now in the fourth quarter, trying to hang on to that lead.
Talk about keeping someone in the game. Instead of being able to shut the door, it's still cracked open because they can come back on you now. The only people really happy about those picks, any fantasy team that has this defense.
First down, and they're going to throw with Allen. Short throw hauled in by Trimble. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down. To the air, Allen. Short throw hauled in by Trimble. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Allen now looks to throw. For Marshall, that's complete. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Throwing now is Allen. Short throw hauled in by Trimble. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came on number. I do my own stunts, don't need a backup. Tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These four pockets full won't fold on me. How you claim me, you my I want
want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. But I still came out number one.
Slipping away. Now I got it, so I